रेस्टोरेंट्स
सर।
ड्यू टू नेटवर्क प्रॉब्लम आई गॉट अ डिसकनेक्टेड सो अप टू सो दिस स्टैटिक कैपेसिटर्स हैव यू अंडरस्टूड या स्टैटिक कैपेसिटर्स हैव यू सीन दिस वन Is it clear this static capacitors? If you connect capacitors in parallel with the load, we can increase the power factor. So here, this is the equipment, three-phase equipment, which consumes the power. So if you have an arc furnace or induction furnace. So here. Due to high value of inductance so here in the equipment the angle between voltage and current will be high so by connecting a capacitor across the load so here capacitor draws so suppose already I have drawn this one so if you connect a capacitor across the load so it will be drawing the leading current so IC so resultant current is V and I here you can see here so the angle between voltage and current that is phi reduces by having a capacitor and also the value of the current will be less compared to IL we are going to reduce the current also so here the current also reduces by placing a capacitor Now here you can connect the capacitors in star. This is delta. You can connect the capacitors in delta or in star. So here the advantages of this static capacitors are, so they have low losses, require little maintenance, as there is no rotating parts. So here, if you take a motor, there will be rotating parts. If you take a capacitor, static capacitor, just it is a equipment static capacitor is a device so if you take a device so capacitor you will be seeing in electronic circuits so like that in electrical system also you have capacitors but of large size so here they require little maintenance as there is no moving parts no rotating parts so the maintenance is less so they can be easily installed as they are light and require no foundation next they can work under ordinary atmospheric conditions so coming to the disadvantages they have short service life ranging from 8 to 10 years so after this we have to replace the capacitors so here they are easily damaged so coming to the disadvantages they are easily damaged if the voltage exceeds the rated value so we must take care So when the voltage rises, we have to disconnect the load. Like that, if you take a, so here they can be easily damaged if a voltage exceeds the rated value. So here, once the capacitors are damaged, their repair is uneconomical. So these are the advantages and disadvantages of static capacitors. So here, what are the advantages of having a improved power factor? So first one is a reduction in load current. As I explained to you that, so here you can see here. So here, you know that P equal to root 3 VL IL cos phi. IL equal to P by root 3 VL cos phi. If power factor reduces, what happens to the current? Current increases. So first one is reduction in load current. How you can say here? You know that P equal to root 3 VL IL cos phi. From this you can write down IL is equal to P by root 3 VL cos phi. So if this power factor reduces, what happens to the current? current increases, and if you and in vice versa, if this cos phi increases, only this cos phi, if this value increases, what happens to the denominator? Denominator increases. So if denominator increases, what happens to the IL? IL reduces. So if IL reduces here, so what are the advantages of improved power factor? So if power factor increases, IL reduces. Okay, if IL reduces, what happens? Voltage drop in the transmission lines and the distribution lines reduces. Okay, if and also the losses reduces, I square R losses reduces in the transmission and distribution lines. So here, reduction in energy loss in the system due to reduction in load current. Okay, next, reduction in KVA loading of the generators. So KVA, so as the current reduces, KVA loading on the generator also reduces. V into I also reduces if current reduces. So all because of due to this increased power factor. If cos phi increases, that means angle between voltage and current reduces, power factor increases. If power factor increases, current reduces. If current reduces, voltage drop reduces. If and also losses in the transmission and distribution losses reduces. Next, KVA loading of the generator also reduces, and also on the transformer. So reduction in KVA loading of the generators and the transformers, which may relieve on overloaded system. Okay, so here, so release capacity for additional growth in the load. You can add a new loads to the system. Okay, so reduction in KVA demand. So reduction in KVA demand charge for large consumers. So KVA demand charge will be there. KVA demand charge. So voltage is constant. If current increases, what happens? There will be KVA demand charge for large consumers. So here, consumers also, there will be some charge. KVA demand charge will be there for factories. So that's why here, due to this, the factories, they will install capacitors. If they install capacitors, this charge on the consumers will be less. So these are the advantages of, so here I have shown only the static capacitors. Actually here, there are synchronous condenser and phase advancers. So what is meant by synchronous condenser? That means this will be studied by triple students. So what is a synchronous condenser means? A synchronous motor, which is over-excited. That is over-excited. Over-excited synchronous motor is known as synchronous condenser. And there will be a slight difference between the synchronous condensers and the phase advancers. Just here, if you mention these names, it is enough. So here, so just please respond in the chat box that have you understood this power factor improvement? Yes or no? So understood power factor improvement? Have you understood? Need of power factor improvement. Have you understood the need of power factor improvement? So have you understood the need of power factor improvement? So I got response from 84, 87, and 89. So what about others? Only three. What about others? Four, five students. Six, seven. Eight, nine, ten. Okay. Okay, what about 119? 119.
Yes, sir.
Have you understood the need of power factor improvement?
Yes, sir.
So what are the problems if you have low power factor? So first of all, what are the causes of low power factor? So you will be having some factories, okay? So just like furnaces, so here arc furnace and induction furnace will be used by some factories. So they are the cause for getting the low power factor. So if they install capacitors, there will be no problem. So here, if you use this furnace, so what happens, the angle between the voltage and current will be high. So if they install capacitor across the load, then what happens? So we can increase the power factor. So how it can be increased? So here, if you have a capacitor, so capacitor current leads the voltage by 90 degrees. So here IL is the current drawn by the induction furnace. Okay, induction furnace. So if you place a capacitor across the furnace, across the equipment, we can reduce the angle between voltage and current. See here, adding this two phasors, IC and IL. So you are going to get the resultant current I. So here the angle between voltage and current will be less, and also the magnitude will be less. Now here the current flowing in the transmission lines and distribution lines also reduces. So if the current reduces, means what happens? So voltage drop reduces and also the losses reduces. We can increase the efficiency and we can connect in new loads. Okay, we can give connection to the new loads, new customers. So here, so first you have to know about the problems with the low power factor. So first problem is increase in the current. So here first one is, if a power factor reduces, the cost phi reduces, what happens? IL increases. If IL increases, what happens? So voltage drop reduces, voltage drop increases. So here the points are clear here. So here, so see the advantages. So here, so advantages of improved power factor. So if power factor increases, if cost phi increases, power factor means cost phi. If cost phi increases, IL reduces. If IL reduces, voltage drop reduces. So if I reduces, means IR reduces. And coming, if I square R reduces, means losses reduces. If losses, so KVA demand loading on the generator. So generator loading also we can reduce. And the transformers can be reduced. So here, see here, here also we can, in the transformer also we can going to reduce the losses. In the generator also we are going to reduce the losses. So if you improve the power factor, current reduces and voltage drop reduces, losses reduces, the loading on the generators and transformers also reduces. Next, reduction in KVA demand charge for large consumers. This also reduces. So here, what is the KVA demand? Kilovolt into kilovolt ampere. V into I. By 1000. So voltage in volts, current in amperes divided by 1000 gives KVA, kilovolt ampere. Okay. So if current reduces, means this also reduces, V into I by 1000. If this reduces, this charge can be reduces, KVA demand charge. So this is about unit 5. Okay, now you can ask any doubt in unit 5. If you have any doubt in unit 5, you can ask. You can see the syllabus also. Okay, you can see the syllabus. See here, see the syllabus of unit 5. The components of LT switchgear. What are the components in switchgear? Switches, fuses, circuit breakers. Okay. So what you have learned about fuses and circuit breakers in your syllabus, you have only miniature circuit breaker to this MCB. So remaining see here. So what are the advantages of fuse and what are the disadvantages of the fuse? Now here, if you see a fuse in the circuit breaker, so there is one advantage of fuse also. So what is the two advantages? So sometimes MCB fails. If MCB fails, it will not work. But if you take a fuse, when a overcurrent flows, the fuse wire will melt, okay, and break the circuit. But there is a disadvantage that it has to be replaced to get the power supply. The fuse wire has to be replaced. That means the fuse must be rewired to get the power supply. So it will take some time. But in MCB, if you take MCB, generally MCB will not get spoiled. So here, if you take MCB, so we can switch off the equipment and we can switch on the MCB. So MCCB for higher values of current, greater than 63 amps. If the current is greater than 63 amps, we go for MCCB. Less than 63 amps, we can use MCB. So MCB less than 63 amperes, we can use MCB. Greater than 63 amperes, we go for MCCB. Next, types of wires and cables. So we have classification of cables. So what is meant by earthing? So in earthing, we have equipment earthing and system earthing. So equipment earthing, system earthing. So types of batteries. So primary and secondary batteries. In primary, we have again classification. In secondary also, we have classification. So important characteristics for batteries. So batteries characteristics I will tell now. Next, elementary calculations for energy consumptions. So one unit of electrical energy is equal to 1 kilowatt hour. 1 kilowatt hour is equal to 1 unit of electrical energy. So next, power factor improvement. So by case, here you have three equipments. One is static capacitor, second one is a synchronous condenser, third one is phase advancers. So static capacitor, you can draw the diagram and you can explain. So the capacitors can be connected in star or delta, and these will be connected in parallel with the load. And battery backup, this I have to explain. So coming to the characteristics for batteries, so let me explain these characteristics for batteries. battery characteristics. So there are three types of characteristics. So there are three types of characteristics. So first one is chemistry. So chemistry. First one is chemistry. Second one is battery capacity. Third one is voltage. So these are the three characteristics. Now chemistry means chemical components. It deals with the chemical components. What are the three chemical components? So if you take the main battery components are lead, nickel, and lithium. Lead, nickel, and lithium. So here they all need a specific designated charger. So here, so charger, we have the charger which is used to charge the batteries. So we need a specific designed charger, okay, to charge the batteries. So this is why charging these batteries on a different charger. If you use a different charger from their own, might cause incorrect charge. So we need a specific designated charger. Okay, we must not charge the batteries with other charger or different charger. Okay, it may, so what a incorrect charge may obtained. So yeah, we are going to charge incorrectly if you use a different charger. So here, despite it is seeming to work at first, so this happens because of different regulatory requirement for each chemistry. So here the charger is an important one. We have to charge the batteries with a specific designated one. We must not charge with different charger, which may result in incorrect charge. So next one is the battery capacity. So here, battery capacity. So can anyone tell their battery capacity used in their mobile phones? 300 mAh. Yeah. Tell me, what is your battery capacity used in mobile phone?
4200 mAh battery.
Yeah. Yes.
Lithium ion
mAh battery, sir.
1000 mAh.
1000 mAh. This is very low.
1000.
4820 mAh. Okay, here the capacity of the battery is expressed in ampere hour, as it is a mobile phone. Milli ampere hour. So here ampere hour is the unit of battery capacity. So here battery capacity is a measure for the charge stored in the battery. So here more capacity means it can store more charge, and you are going to have more backup. So typically in ampere hour, this is mAh is milli ampere hour. So here battery capacity is a measure of the charge stored by the battery. More capacity means it can store more charge. There are other units. So those are watt hour, kilowatt hour, or ampere hour. The most common measure of battery capacity is ampere hour. So this is the most common measure. Most common measure is ampere hour. Or for the low devices, so ampere hour. So here the batteries which we use in automobiles will be rated in, their capacity will be in ampere hours. So for mobile phone battery, they will be in milli ampere hour for mobile phone batteries. So for large batteries, the capacity will be in ampere hour. So next one is the voltage. So here a battery features a nominal voltage. okay. So rated voltage will be there for each and every battery. So if you take a AA battery or AAA battery, so the voltage rating is 1.5 volts. So for your cell phone battery, if you take your mobile phone battery, it will be 5 volts, okay? You are using a charger to charge the battery. The output voltage of the capacitor will, output voltage of the battery, sorry, the output voltage of the charger will be 5 volts. You can see the this ratings on the charger also, 5 volt charger. So here, so different batteries will have different charge. So a battery features a nominal voltage, okay, along with the amount of cells. So cells here, if you can see here, if you see an emergency lamp or if you see a battery of your laptop, so it will be having cells. So some batteries will be having 6 cells, some batteries will be having 9 cells. Okay, so here, a battery features a nominal voltage along with the amount of cells connected in series. So here, coming to this one, if you see a, I will show this one. So if you see these batteries, so here in our remotes we use these are AAA batteries in our TV remote we use these AAA batteries. Here these are used in wall clocks, AA clock, okay. If you see the size and diameter, so the AAA batteries will have less length, so the distance between positive terminal and negative terminal will be less when compared to AA battery, okay. So this quad A batteries I will show here afterwards. So you know this AAA batteries and AA batteries. So AAA batteries are used in TV remote and remote of the AC also have AAA battery. And if you have a setup box, that remote also uses this, mostly they will be using this AAA batteries. Now if you take a wall clock, they will be having AA batteries. Next, you might have seeing this C type, if you see this C type, the diameter will be very high and these two will be having the same length. So here length is also given, so length is same for AA and C.
Sir, in some remotes using AA type also, no, sir?
Mostly, I'm saying that mostly. Which remote is using AA battery? Setup box remote. Yeah, some setup boxes will be there.
Setup box, yes, TV remote only, sir.
So once again?
In TV remote only, sir, not setup box.
Okay, they may be older ones. Okay. So mostly they will be using this AAA. Most of the TV remotes, they will be using this AAA battery. Some may be there, they will be using AA. So if you take these wall clocks, most of the wall clocks or all the, I have seen all the wall clocks are using this AA batteries. So next, C type, if you see the length of this C type and AA, the length will be same, but here the diameter of C type will be high. So this will be providing more current than AA. So C type will be providing more current than AA. Next, D type. So D type will be having more diameter and more length compared to C type. So this will be having more current carrying capacity. So it will, the current drawn from this battery will be more than C type. Okay, you can see the diameter and the length. So you have F type battery also. So if you see the F type battery, F size battery, So the diameter will be same for this D and F, but the length is more for F. So here it provides more current compared to D. So here if you see this, all these batteries, the current will be, so here the length and the diameter will be changing, and here, so F will be carrying, supplying more current compared to others. So the current carrying capacity will increase, current delivering capacity will be increased from quad A to F. F will be providing more current than D, D will be providing more current than C, like this. So you can see the sizes also. So quad A, you generally will not see. So I will show that quad A batteries also. So triple A and double A, you will be seeing more. Triple A and double A. So here, these are the lengths. This is the diameter and this is the length. So if you see double A and C, the length is same, but the diameter of C will be high. If you compare D and F, the diameter is same, but the length of F is high. So this is just for information. So here, next I will show this another one. So have you seen this one, this type of battery? So here, if you see this 9 volts battery will be there, that will be containing 6 quad A batteries in series. So, but
it reveals 6 quad A case videos. Just a humble energizer.
So this is a battery which is of 9 volts. This is a 9 volts battery, right? This is a 9 volts battery. You'll be seeing this in project kits. So this is a 9 volts battery. It will be containing 6 quad A batteries, which are connected in series. If you connect 6 quad A batteries in series, you are going to get this 9 volts battery. So here 6 batteries means, so here 1.5 into 6, what is 1.5 into 6? Yeah, please respond. 1.5 into 6 is 9 volts. Yeah,
and the base plate get taken off, it reveals.
So here, this 9 volts battery contains 6 quad A batteries.
6 quad A cells. And they will come out.
Okay, but you must not remove this one. So here you can see the caution here, or caution on the 9 volts battery. So first one is may explode or leak if recharged. So we must not recharge this 9 volts battery. So may explode or leak if recharged, and if inserted improperly. We must not insert this improperly, and mix it with a different battery. We must not mix this 9 volts with other batteries like 1.5 volts like that. We must not mix this battery with other batteries. And here, do not open battery. In the video, he has opened the battery, but do not open the battery. It may explode. So here, what is the caution? May explode or leak if recharged, inserted improperly, mixed with the different battery types. There will be voltage difference, right? Mixed with the different battery types or disposed of in fire. So if you would put this battery in fire, it may explode. So may explode or leak if recharged, inserted improperly, mixed with different battery types, or disposed in fire. Do not open battery. Okay. So this why I have shown means just to give information about the quad A battery. So generally this you will be seeing this double A and triple A, but quad A you will not be seeing, but they will be in that 9 volts battery. So if you connect this, all the batteries will be having a voltage of 1.5 volts. See here, 1.5 volts. All these batteries will have a voltage of 1.5 volts, but current provided by these batteries will increase from quad A to F. Next here, if you connect six batteries in series, 6 into 1.5, which is equal to 9 volts. So here, in this way, we are going to get this 9 volts. Okay, this will be this. So here, this is a 9 volts battery. So how you are going to get the 9 volts means by connecting six quad A batteries in series, each of 1.5 volts.
And the base plate get taken off.
So you can see, so six batteries are there, which will be connected in series.
Six quad A cells. And they will come out. And they're not even spot welded. Just put together with a pressure plate.
But remember that you must not open this one. So here, this is the caution. So do not open battery. So just for information, I have shown, but do not open battery. See here. So cells connected in series. Suppose if you take a emergency lamp. So sometimes if the power goes, we'll be using rechargeable lamps. So in that, we are using the 6 volts battery. So how you are going to get 6 volts means, so 3 will be connected in series, 3 into 2 volts. So 3 into 2 volts, we are going to get 6 volts. So cells are connected in series to get the required voltage. So here, voltage. A battery features a nominal voltage along with the amount of cells connected in series. Chemistry provides the open circuit voltage, which will be about 5 to 7% higher on a fully charged battery. So here it is important to check the correct nominal voltage of battery before connecting it. So correct nominal voltage of the battery, we have to check before connecting. So correct nominal voltage of battery, we have to check. It is important to check the correct nominal voltage of a battery before connecting it. So next, cold cranking amps. So cold cranking amps. So every starter battery is marked with cold cranking amps, also abbreviated CCA. The number denotes the amount of amps that the battery is able to provide at minus degrees C. So at minus degrees C, the amount of current the battery is able to provide is nothing but cold cranking amps. See here, it is abbreviated as CCA. The number denotes the amount of amperes that the battery is able to provide at minus 18 degrees C. So these are the characteristics of the batteries. So first one is chemistry. We must use a specific designed charger. Second one is the battery capacity. It will be in mAh or ampere hour. So you have other other measurements like watt hours, kilowatt hours. So the most common measure is ampere hour and voltage. So you will be having a nominal voltage, and you have to check the correct nominal voltage of battery before connecting it. Next one is CCA. So it denotes the amount of amps the battery is able to provide at minus 18 degrees C. So here you, if you see this syllabus, so here only this topic I have to cover, ELCB I have to cover. So all the topics I have covered. So once, if you have any doubts, you can ask me. If you have doubts or if you want explanation further, you can ask me now. So once you go through this ELCB, it is there in the notes also. Well, once you see this ELCB, earth leakage circuit breaker. So once you learn this one, once you read this one, so in the next class I will explain this one, ELCB. So it is mainly used to protect the human life against electric shocks. So MCB, MCCB will not provide protection, but ELCB will provide protection against electric shock. So there are two types: voltage earth leakage circuit breaker, current earth leakage circuit breaker. Two types. Okay. So once you go through this, I will explain this in the next class. So let me take the attendance now. Number 68.